CPI leader and former JNU Students Union President Kanhaiya Kumar and independent Gujarat MLA from Vadgam constituency Vignesh Mevani today joined Congress in the presence of Rahul Gandhi in Delhi. Kumar had joined CPI ahead of the 2019 Lok Sabha election. Posters welcoming him in Congress were seen outside the Congress office in Delhi today. Navjot Singh Sidhu today resigned as president of the Punjab Pradesh Congress Committee 2 months after assuming the post. In a letter addressed to Sonia Gandhi, Sidhu said, "The collapse of a man's character stems from the compromise corner. I can never compromise on Punjab's future and the agenda for Punjab's welfare." He said he'll continue to serve the Congress party. Aviation regulator DGCA has issued a directive asking airlines and air navigation service providers to conduct drug tests for their flight crew members and air traffic controllers. It said such testing will begin from January 31st next year. Employers will have to randomly test at least 10% of the employees hired by them every year, it added. India's drug regulator has allowed Covishield maker Serum Institute of India SII to enroll children aged between 7 to 11 years for its COVID-19 vaccine trial, Reuters reported. The Central Drugs Standard Control Organization's subject matter expert panel made the recommendation after detailed deliberation. Serum Institute of India is already conducting a trial of its COVID-19 vaccine in the 12 to 17 age group. The COVID-19 virus is expected to continue to transmit for a very long time, senior WHO official Poonam Khetrapal Singh said. A multitude of factors will decide whether the virus will become endemic in the long run. Chief among them is the level of immunity in a community, both through vaccination and previous infection, she added. Women will no longer be allowed to attend classes or work at the Kabul University, the institution's Taliban-appointed chancellor, Mohammad Ashraf Gherard, announced. They won't be allowed as long as real Islamic environment isn't provided for all, he said on his Twitter account. Earlier, female students were forced to attend a pro-Taliban gathering in head-to-toe black robes at Kabul University. China has unveiled a high-altitude and long-endurance drone that can fly for around 20 hours and reach top speeds of 700 km per hour. The Kaihong 6 drone, unveiled at Airshow China 2021, has a maximum takeoff weight of 7.8 tons and can carry a large range of payloads, including air-to-ground missiles and bombs. It can also carry out anti-submarine missions.